thanks so much for coming back to Jake's Face Reacts. I'm continuing my... It's like I always have to have like a sort of mission, or I just get kind of lost and confused. So my mission now is to go back through, I think, the year 2000 and look at the runners up, the second place songs from Eurovision. I've done the first place songs for those years. This, because the last one I posted, I think, was 2013, right? And the runner-up for that one was, and I didn't know this, was a guy from Azerbaijan, and then you guys were saying in the comments that they, like, well, I don't even want to say it. But 2012 is this video, so here we go. This is the runner-up from 2012 Eurovision. If I'm not mistaken, the winner of Eurovision 2012 was the lady that sang Euphoria, right, from Sweden? Loreen, is that right? Which was incredible. You can go back. I've made a reaction video to that. I still think that song could compete like every year up to this year and possibly still win, because that's how good that song was. So, this is Russia again. Okay, so they're the runner up again. They were the runner up the last time I saw them, with the blonde lady, Paulina something. Seen about a million hearts, something like that. She was good. But let's see how they became the runner up in 2012. All that is on my screen, it says, oh dear, I'm not good with names. The runner up from Russia 2012, their name is, her name, I don't know if it's her, Baranovskaya Babushki. Doesn't babushki mean like grandmother, grandma? Maybe it's a guy. I literally on my screen right now see, it looks like the outside of a stadium, like with the colors from the Russian flag, so I can't even get like a hint of what this is about. But let's see how Baranovskaya Babushki is. That sounds interesting. The song is called Party for Everybody. Huh. Okay, let's go.
Oh.
Okay, every once in a while, there comes along, a performance where I doubt seriously that I clicked on the correct link or I typed the information in right. 2012 Eurovision Song Contest, second place. Baranovsky Babushke, Party for Everybody. Second place. What? I mean, I'm kind of speechless for one of the first times. Like, I don't. Okay, I will say this, the name makes a little bit more sense now that I've adjusted. I don't even know if I have adjusted to the awkwardness, but I Babushki, like I said earlier, is like a grandmother, right? So it must be like the grandmothers of, and then a place called Baranovsky. Is that right, Russia? Am I right about that? Okay, my question is, did you have a national selection? And if so, how did this win your national selection? It seems like sort of a trend, right? Where like if some countries send, and you told me what it's called now, it's called a novelty act, that they actually sometimes come in second place, quite often. I mean, I don't even know what to say musically about that because their only prop was like an oven and they baked something in the oven. And that I don't even like what? Russia, you confuse me, man. That is very confusing. I love grandmothers. I think they're awesome and sweet. Do I think they should be competing in Eurovision? Probably not. Was it kind of catchy? Yes, the chorus. But that was just kind of, whoa, like, what did I just watch? All right. And it kind of makes me wonder, like, what other songs from this year were like third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10th place, because I have a feeling that not everyone sent a novelty act, so there had to have been some real songs in this one that were sort of ranked underneath this. I don't know. That was I don't think I'm gonna forget that one, Russia. I mean, I'm sorry. I don't think if I go back and watch my reaction to that, which I probably won't, I have a feeling that my mouth probably didn't close the entire time because I was trying to process what I was seeing and hearing. Okay. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.